Hey guys, Abby Casey here with American Airgunner, and today I'm going to be doing an unboxing of the Crosman Shockwave. I ran to Walmart today, got this airgun. This is a regular old brake barrel, and it's been a long time since I've shot one of these. So we're going to do a little bit of accuracy testing, show you what this airgun is all about, because this airgun comes in at a really affordable price. Walmart sold me this airgun for $128. Love Crosman, they make some really great airguns, and this one is very affordable, and we're just gonna talk about it and see how it does on the range. Okay, let's go over the basics of what Crosman is advertising here. So this is the Shockwave. It comes in a 177 and a 22 caliber, and I've just picked up the 22 because I like 22 calibers. A two-stage adjustable trigger, a 5-year warranty. I'm not sure really what that all entails. With alloy pellets, they're saying it comes in at 950 feet per second. And with lead pellets, it's coming in at 850 feet per second. So pick your poison with that, whether or not you want to have a harder punch or if you want a screaming pellet. So I know a lot of the brake barrels that I used to use as a kid, they were very, very loud. And I'm really excited to dig into this airgun because it says it's very, very quiet. And that is one of the reasons why we all love to shoot airguns, is because it's not blowing your ears out and you don't have to wear hearing protection. So it is a 22 airgun, so it's going to be great for plinking in the backyard, taking care of small pests. It is a brake barrel, so you don't have to carry around a big heavy tank. You can just break the barrel, hence the name, and you got your air power. So let's open it up and see what's inside. Ah, there it is. We have an airgun in the box. Oh, I love new airguns. Gotta love that new airgun smell. There's the scope, it's 4x32. If you don't wanna use this, then it also has iron sights, and it also has a dovetail on the barrel, so you can switch out your scopes or do whatever you want, because let's all be real, we're air gunners and we tinker with everything. Also came with scope rings, that's great. Has some more instructions in there on how to put that scope on, but who even reads directions? I don't. Okay, I just said I don't read instructions or manuals or anything, but here I am picking up a manual, and I'm glad I did, because not only does this come in a 177, a 22, it also comes in a 25. It's got a synthetic stock, it's got a dovetail rail, comes with iron sights. This is the suppressor, gonna make the airgun super quiet, hopefully. Safety is in the trigger guard, right here. That frog, you better be careful. Safety is in the trigger guard. It tells you right here in little writing that that is on fire, and that is on safe. This is where the barrel breaks. It's been a long time since I've done this. Oh my God. There we go. I'm so used to shooting PCPs, I'm weak now. This is where you place your pellet, and then you would close it, and then the air gun is charged. Now we have our scope rings that came in the packaging. There's actually a pre-drilled hole into the barrel of the air gun, and there's a screw that goes through the middle of this ring and goes into that pre-drilled hole. So for extra stability, they have that set up for you. But we're just gonna eyeball it and wing it, because we're only gonna shoot 25 yards and 50 yards. Got my target set up there, about 15 yards. Let's just see how it starts out. This is the Crosman pellet it recommended. Seat that right there. Go ahead and close it. And remember, it tells you right here what your safety is. So right now it's on safe, and here's fire. Let's see where it goes. Hi. The good thing about brake barrels is it'll make you get some muscles, which I clearly need. We almost put it in the same hole there, top left. So we're gonna come down, and we're gonna come right. The barrel's smoking. Guess that means we're coming in hot. Trigger's actually pretty smooth. It's a heavy trigger, but it's not crunchy. It's actually kind of smooth. Well, we got it to go right. It didn't go down at all. I'm getting the hang of the brake barrel, guys. Still shooting high. All right, we're gonna take one more shot with the scope. 15 clicks down, and the scope just isn't wanting to cooperate, which, you know, is a $150-something gun and scope, so you get what you pay for with that. But it does have iron sights, and sometimes those are just the best thing to go with. Shot in the same hole. Let's take off this scope and just shoot with iron sights. So I want to show you guys what's going on right here. There's my group at 15 or 20 yards. I can't get the scope to really move. So I'm not gonna fool the scope anymore and I'm just gonna shoot my iron sights. Let's get rid of these and put up a new target. New target on the board. Come along, let's shoot air guns. That's probably all bouncy with my mic. I am super happy with how quiet this air gun is. There's several other air guns that I've shot that, you know, are like from Walmart and they're pretty loud, but this one is very quiet. I know all you big strong guys out there would be able to do this a lot easier than me because I got chicken arms. Okay, let's see where it goes with iron sights. I think I just hit a bullseye. It's touching the orange. See, I just love regular old iron sights. Sometimes you just gotta go back to the basics. See if we can do it again. Just a little bit high of that. Still shooting a little bit high. Okay, that did, well, it went where I adjusted, which was down. I wanna get a 5-shot group going for you guys to see. That's 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's see where this fifth one goes. Hi. One thing I would like to see on this air gun, like I said, the front sight is just molded into the barrel. It would be nice to have a little fiber optic or something because the front sight is so dark up against that specific target. It kind of melds into it a little bit. Maybe I'll put a little piece of paint up there or something so I can see the tip of my sight. Oh, my left or right is really good. The vertical keeps going like this, but let's go take a look at that group. So you can see where I was messing with the vertical, but the left to right's really good. And I didn't hit a bullseye, but from back there, it looked like it kind of was. Just touched, barely touching the orange. All right, I put up a fresh target. Low. I'm not gonna touch the sights. I'm just gonna keep rolling with what I got. Oh! Okay, I'm like, happy with this group. I'm sure I could play with this a little bit more and get the sights to go up, but I really just want to show you guys the kind of group that you can get with this air rifle. I think the secret is just to tinker with it a little bit more and then it'll be dialed. So that was 4 shots. Got a group that's touching down there, but let's go take a look at this group. Not bad. Not bad. So like I was saying, I didn't touch the sights at all for this one. I just kept it where it was at and it produced a pretty nice little group. All right, let's review the targets that we've shot here. Sorry, this one's kind of messed up because I stuck it on. I put another target on top of it. So this is with the scope, me just originally trying to get it dialed in. This is with the scope as well. And it came in a little bit tighter, but I also wanted to test it without the scope and just shoot iron sights here. And I was playing with the up and down, the vertical, and that's what I got. And as you can see, it was good left or right, but vertical was having some issues. And then finally just left it alone and shot a pretty decent little group right here. And that's what I'm gonna call the winner. Throughout the day, I'm gonna play with it some more and see if I can't get it to come up more centered, but not touching the sights anymore and just seeing if I could get a tight group. That's what I came up with. And I was shooting the Crosman hollow point 14.3 grain. Yeah, fun little gun to shoot. Think I'll keep this one around the house just because it is a break barrel and you don't have to fill it up with air or anything. And It was a lot of fun to shoot. All right, guys, that is the review on the Crosman Shockwave. This is an awesome little break barrel for around $150. You might be able to find it cheaper somewhere else than Walmart, but I haven't done a ton of research on price point with it, but affordable break barrel. Got a pretty decent group there with my iron sights. Maybe go ahead and make the investment and buy a little bit better scope. I just didn't have time to tinker around with that as much today as I wanted. But I was able to get a great group with the iron sights. And like I said, I was shooting the Crosman 14.3 grain pellets here. You could try some different pellets. You might be able to even get a tighter group than that. So if you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit the subscribe button, hit the like button. We're on TikTok, Facebook, and Instagram too, posting all different kinds of content on there. Hope you enjoyed it. I'm Abby Casey with American Airgunner.